Today we're going to try something fun. We are going to not transmit DMX out into moving lights media servers as we have done so many times before. Today is about putting DMX into the console and utilizing that to trigger different things inside the GrandMA3. Putting DMX into a console is really valuable. You can use like cheap control surfaces, small cheap DMX boards to trigger different things. So it's a way of getting the console to be more powerful. If you want to extend your use of faders and stuff like that, you can use DMX in and have an extra board next to you with a lot of extra faders. So today's video is about DMXing into the GrandMA3. We start here on the screen. You can see our universes. You can see I have put something on 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. There's nothing on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we want to try to put some DMX into the console. The way we do that is we, first of all, we go up and we check if there's anything on the DMX line, which there isn't in this case. And then we go into our settings in here. We go into our connector configuration and we see the different colors in here. If you have port A through to F, they are green. That means they are outputs. You can configure any DMX socket on a GrandMA3 to be an input, an output, to be RDM compatible. I mean, there's many different things you can do. So if we want to change port F here to an input, we can simply right-click it. We can right-click the mode here, and then you can see we can turn it off. It could be an output, it could be RDM, and it could be an input. In this case, we just close this one down because port number 7 right now is configured as an input. So we need to put a DMX line into port number 7, as we do right here, and then we need some sort of device that can transmit DMX. In my case, I have this small little DMX tester here. This is what we are going to use, and I have a small camera set up here so we can see exactly what's going on. So we power up the transmitter right here. You can see our little camera here, ProLite Datamaster, which is pretty simple tool to use. We go into send DMX like this, and then we simply take channel number 1 and put it all the way up to 255. So now we are transmitting a DMX signal on channel number 1 from the outlet on the Datamaster, and we need to go into the console now and set up some different things to receive DMX. The first thing you want to do is you want to go into your input-output mode here, and we start by enabling the input like this. And then we can go back into our universes over here and we can use our swipey and edit. And you can see right now the merge mode is set to off. If you want to click on it, it's set to preview. And in this case, I just want to do some HTTP merging. So right now it's closed down. We set our DMX universe number 1 to merge DMX. But you can see right here, there's nothing coming in on DMX channel number 1, which is the one we are transmitting. So what we need to do is we need to go back into the connector configuration and we go up into port number 7, we right click and we set it to, instead of putting in universe on universe number 7, we set this down to universe number 1. And as you can see, when we apply, suddenly we are receiving DMX over here. So what I can do now is I can change from percent here and put it into decimal, and that is going to give us the exact reading of the DMX signal being received by the console. So now we know that if we take our data master here again and we take the DMX channel and we start by taking it up or down, you can see it goes to 0, and you can see if you follow the decimals over here, you can see I am in complete control of what's coming in on this channel right now. So on universe number 1, channel number 1, we are in control of the DMX signal, and now we need to figure out what to do with it, because now we are putting a signal into the GrandMA. It doesn't do anything right now, so we need to configure some sort of action the console can take when we put DMX signals into it. So to do that, we need to go back into our settings here, and we need to go down to this one called in and out. And you can see all the different ones. You have DC remotes, MIDI remotes, DMX, OSC, and PSN. We want to work here in DMX remotes, and we want to do this up here. We want to enable the input so we can work with it. So we enable that, And now we need to configure some sort of action down here. So what we can do now is we can insert a new DMX remote and we can enable it and we can say, okay, what address do you want to listen to? Where do you want to take your information from? So in our case, we right click and we say universe one, address number one. So now we have configured it to listen to the address we are inputting right now. So now we need to tell it what to do, basically. So what we can do is we can simply take one of our existing sequences here. And in my case, we could take the blinders. We have a sequence here called blinder odd, which is just half of the blinders. And we can say we need the fader to be master. We need it to trigger on zero and we need to trigger it all the way up to 255. So basically, this is all we need to do. So now if we go over here to our blind odd and our blind even, we should be able to do some sort of control here. You can see now the fader jumped up, and if you look at the 3D, I'm actually starting to turn on our blinders right here. So this is basically working. So what we could do now, if we go all the way above 255, you will see it turns off. And if I go all the way back to 100, it turns back on. So now DMX channel number one is in complete control of this fader. So what we could do now is we could copy this line here and we could set this one to be our even blinders, and we can set this one to master as well. Everything here is the same. So as soon as I once again take the DMX remote and I start wiggling the numbers, you can see now I control both of the faders. So you could imagine having a small DMX console, and then you could simply just put some of your HTP faders on the console. So that just gives you extra room to work with, especially if you're working with a command wing or something with limited faders. Another fun thing we could do is we could insert a new DMX remote and we can say on a different channel, on universe one, channel number two, we could do something different. And we can say, what do we want to do? We want to target a sequence, for instance. And what do I have selected right now? I could go down to one of my songs here, this one, and then I could select nothing for the fader, but I could say, okay, I want to trigger an action on this fader. So I could go down to a Go Plus, for instance, and I can say now the trigger could be from 10% all the way up to 25%. So what happens when we start increasing the DMX value on channel number two? You can see nothing happens until we hit, I think, 25%. Then it starts to activate that cue. And again, we can use this trigger for many, many different things. Let's say, for instance, we need to trigger a macro. We can say on channel number three on universe one, we put in our target here and we go into macro. And we could just maybe switch the page. And we could do that. We just leave this one here and we can say go. As soon as I hit 191%, it should trigger a macro that's gonna go to the next page. So let's see what happens when we start turning this one up. As soon as we hit 191%, we should trigger a macro that's gonna cue into the next page. And to be able to see what's happening, I'm just gonna put in down here, you can see there's a specific song going right now. And if I go past 191, it triggered to the next song. So that's the power of DMXing into the GrandMA3 console. You can easily extend your user interface with buttons and faders from different, maybe cheaper manufacturers, just simple DMX consoles. As long as you can transmit an HTTP DMX signal, you're fine. And then you can have maybe house lights, or maybe you could have some extra faders for your HTTP things on the console if you are using a command wing or something with less faders. So that's the power of DMX into the GrandMA3. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. Otherwise, I hope to see you next time. And if you like this content, be sure to subscribe to the channel and click the little bell notification. That way you're gonna get notified every time I upload a new video. So until next time, see ya. Bye-bye.